All right, guys, I am super, super excited. I've got Messenger Bot Pro Jeffery Banek here today to talk all about Messenger Bots. Jeffery, welcome to the e-commerce empire builders, man.
Thanks, Pete. Appreciate it.
So we're going to start today off by Jeff's going to give a little bit of his backstory. Like, how did he, where he came from, essentially, like his backstory. How did he find internet marketing? What led him to be in his position today? So if you don't mind sharing that with everybody, Jeff.
Yeah, it's been a long, crazy journey. I originally started out actually in fitness, doing personal training and running gyms and things like that. And I was developing my own business or boot camp and things. And I was learning about marketing then, you know, about making landing pages and ads and all that type of stuff. But on the fitness space, and I've been doing that since about like 2010. Had some minor success, but a lot of more failures actually. Then in, March of last year, roughly, I was introduced to, Russell Brunson and .com Secrets, and I read his book, and, it was able to, link everything together, and it all made sort of sense then, you know, upsells and downsells and the whole process behind that. And then from there, I got this tattoo for anyone that's watching the actual video here, which I saw all this coming in ClickFunnels. I knew it was going to be something big. So I got this tattoo as a promise to myself. I was going to do something big in ClickFunnels, however you want to put it. And about 2 weeks after that, there was a message in the group that was like, hey, wouldn't you like to help me with funnels? And prior to that, I had just been learning about ClickFunnels. If people would be in the ClickFunnels group, I'd answer questions, jump on Zooms, whatever it took to help them out. Plus, I was learning ClickFunnels the whole entire time. You know, when you really can teach something, you know, you've mastered it. And this guy puts in the post, he's like, hey, I need help with my funnels. And I just got an award. The first time they ever done this, they put out the top 10 contributors to the group. And I was actually awarded second highest contributor out of 78,000 people at the time. So that's, I told Kevin, this guy's name was Kevin. I'm like, well, here's my resume. You know, I've done a couple of funnels and things. And then I just got this award in the group. He's like, well, let's do it. About 2 months later, we launched. And then 57 days later, we'd done $1.2 million through one of my funnels.
That's amazing.
The funny thing was, is that like on the road to get there, I mean, I actually was homeless at one point, living in a car. I mean, like my wife and I were now married, but when I was learning about digital marketing and everything, I wasn't having as much success as I was now. And she was like supporting us while she worked. I was trying to hone my craft and it was rough. I mean, there's even a point where we had to like pawn our wedding ring to be able to pay rent. I mean, it got really bad. And, but now it's been amazing. In the last year, I've had this meteoric rise with all the success, and I've been able to finally put my skills to light. And like, for instance, Kevin's Messenger Bot, we were talking about that. We started really pushing it March 1st, and we're up over 100,000 subscribers now on his Messenger Bot. So yeah, I've had a lot of great success, but the road to get here was not easy by any means.
Isn't it funny? It's like everybody's story. It's like there always is that like absolute storm that happens before you actually get some sort of success, before you see a light at the end of the tunnel. Like I tell people, I've been in internet marketing for like 10 years. Like literally only the past like 4 that I've actually like been able to pay myself, be able to leave my job and like, you know, support my life. And like a lot of people come into this space especially and they're like, oh, you know what? This stuff doesn't work. They'll try it for a month or two or even a year. And they're like, oh, this isn't for me, you know?
But that's what separates. No, me too. I mean, like I've been trying to figure out this game since like 2010 almost. And it's only been, like I said, the last year or so that everything's caught on, I get, and then I've been able to have such success. So yeah, it's been a journey, but it's amazing where I'm at now. I mean, I was lucky enough to go to ClickFunnels viral launch and meet Gary Vee and all those. I set the world record with ClickFunnels for the largest ever human bubble soccer game.
That's awesome.
You know, I got the 2-comma just in March. We actually were on stage and got the 2-comma award here. And now for Kevin, my main guy, in right at a year, we were on the fit roughly a year ago now. And he's just right about 4 million we've done through his course.
That's insane. Those are numbers like everybody, and they're achievable, right? Like,
oh yeah, for sure.
You just got
to. For sure, I've got a couple people now that I'm super excited about. We're about to I'm probably gonna do way better than that. We're looking at, you know, like the 10x awards. Like, what multiple of 10x are we looking about? 10 million or 100 million? It's crazy some of the numbers I talk about now. And I mean, it's literally,
yeah,
to talk about people and be like, oh, 100,000 for this or a million for this, and it's like reality now. When I used to live paycheck to paycheck, bro. I mean, like, literally, I was that guy that, prime example, okay? We went to go to rent jet skis. We had a friend in town. And they didn't tell me, but they took $800 deposit down off my card without telling me. You would have done that a year ago, and I would have been like, oh, I can't pay rent. What the? Oh, I mean, if I even had $800 on the card for them to take off in the first place, you know? I mean, like, I told my wife, thank God that we're in this spot now, because literally, it's amazing. I go, a year ago, that would have destroyed us. Like, literally destroyed us. We would have had to, like, take a loan out or something. And now, I mean, thank goodness I'm in a better place than I was able to. But that's just that. It's been an amazing journey to go from that type of destruction for $800 to now where, you know, it sucked, but it wasn't an amazing deal.
And it's amazing, like, what ClickFunnels did for, like, the community. Oh. Because, like, think about it. Like, even 4 years ago when nobody even really knew what ClickFunnels was, like, I mean, they've created so many millionaires. And, like, that possibility of showing people that it's achievable, right? And seeing it, like, seeing all those people walk across stage, you're like, oh, that person's normal, just like me. Like, I can achieve the same thing. And now, with the Two Comma Club X Award that they have, it's like, oh, wait, I can hit that, too. Like, they're just normal people, too. You know,
It even blows you even more, your mind more when they had a dinner for us at ClickFunnels for the Two Comma Award winners, where they took us into Disneyland. We had a special performance and all this cool stuff. But talking to the other people, they are, like, so many of them are just normal people. I mean, like, I'm trying to think, I can't think of her name all of a sudden, but she was this one lady that she was doing the personal trainer one day. She was doing squats, and because she'd had a baby, apparently as you have, women have babies, they're not able to hold their bladder as well. And on video, she went to the bathroom and she realized that this was a problem, made a book on how to exercise, on a course on how to solve that problem, sold it for only $37 and has one of those now.
Yeah. I know who you're talking about.
I forget. Rachel Holtzman or something.
Yeah,
she's
Hudson a huge influencer. I mean, doesn't she have like a million? Yeah. She has millions of followers.
She does. Literally, her Instagram account is like, I believe, in the millions. I cannot think of her name to save my life right now. But that's just a prime example, though, that normal person was just personal trainer and that blew her up. I'm going to make a course about these people. They're obviously interested in this problem they saw on YouTube.
Yeah.
And she's like, boom, made a course. But that's a thing, too. That's like, I have two clients right now. One's Kevin David, who teaches beginning how to sell Amazon FBA, like how to sell stuff on Amazon. And then I have some other more advanced, or like doing wholesale and other higher level strategies. And one of the funny thing was, is one of my other guys, like, Kevin's stuff's really great. His information's so good, but it's more geared towards newer people getting into the industry, where he's like, I'm trying to hit the experts and all that. And I go, really? I go, that's great. We're going to do that. We're going to charge more and all this. But realize there's always going to be more beginners than experts.
Mm-hmm.
And here's the thing. When you teach beginners, you only have to know more than the beginners. You know, like when you're teaching experts, you have to know really high level and be able to break it down. You only, and they teach that in Expert Secrets, really have to know more than the people you're teaching. Because as long as I know more than them, I am the expert, you know?
And there's honestly, like me, I've only started kind of like helping, showing people, like, because I hit the Two Comma Club Award too. Unfortunately, it's not here yet.
Oh, congratulations, brother. That's awesome.
So I hit that.
I saw your post, actually. Yeah. I saw your post.
I got Akbar's award. Well, right over there, but I guess he's quicker with it. And I hit that in the e-commerce business that I had. And, like, I sold that business, like, about a month ago. And, like, honestly, like, it's crazy. Like, I've been teaching people that same process that I went through.
Right.
And, like, it's amazing actually seeing people, it work for other people. I mean, it's like, it's mm-hmm. honestly helped me grow more so. It's like, selfishly, like, my businesses were doing better because I'm like, oh man, I have my hands in so many of my, like, my mentees and people inside of my, like, programs. And seeing their businesses, like, it actually helped me more so than I think it potentially could have helped them. It's insane, right? They're getting results, I'm getting results. It's like, it's honestly a great growing experience, too.
Yeah, the internet's amazing, man. And one thing I found, it's like, the more I tend to give to people, want to help people, like, no one's going to ever learn everything you're going to know. So just give away the farm. You know what I mean? Like, help people, because like my business right now, I'm blessed that I don't do any advertising. I literally can't take any more clients. I had to turn someone away the other day because I just can't take any more clients. You know, it's amazing. It's a great thing to have, but that's just because I'm constantly delivering value to people and helping people out. And because of that, they want to reciprocate and do for me. So, you know,
exactly.
It's a great thing, man.
Yeah. All right. So let's start talking about what I brought you on here for. So Messenger bots. So there's probably, I put out some videos showing basic setups for Messenger bots. I'm no pro at it by any means, but for the people that are like brand spanking new to Messenger bots, they've honestly maybe have never heard of it. Just can you give a rundown? Like, what is a Messenger bot exactly, and why do you care about it? Why does anyone care about it?
Well, two great questions there. First of all, Messenger bots are the Messenger app inside of Facebook that you communicate with, whether it's your friends or whatever. They'll send you a message, hey, we're getting ready to go out to dinner, and you type back to them, and that's all on Facebook. That is Facebook Messenger itself. Now, as marketers, we can actually send people messages through that platform using things like third-party platforms like ManyChat's really big, ChatFuel. Those are the two major platforms that are the easiest to use right now and most robust. Now, what happens here, what the great thing about it is it's similar to email, and people have called it email 2.0, but it's not really. Where an email, first of all, I can send you out emails 3 to 5 days a week, you know, and that's not that big of a deal. If someone's getting a bing in their message every day, the average person is not ready for that engagement right now. For emails, you can do as many as you want, 5 to 6 days, but really for Messenger, 1 to 3 messages a week. Like, and I'm talking about 3 messages when someone's hyper engaged and want to get your content. Anything above that, it becomes obtrusive in your Messenger box. So that's something you should always keep in mind when setting up Messenger. Now, the other thing that's really great about it is that when you're engaging with someone, I think the main problem people have when comparing, again, email to Messenger is email is very static. I'm going to send you something. You're going to read it. You're going to decide to engage. It usually goes to maybe a landing page or something like that. A Messenger you send, it's supposed to be engaging. It's all about the conversation. Realize Facebook doesn't care anything about you or I. They only care about engagement and the experience the customer on their end is having. So you want, when people engage with a Messenger bot, for it to be a good experience. Now, what's the number one thing someone likes to talk about? Themselves, right? Like, everybody likes to talk about themselves. So use that sort of against someone in Messenger. Ask them questions. For instance, let's say you're trying to do an e-com product, all right? There might be certain price points or certain ways that you want to break it down. So, for instance, let's do wine or something. Let's do wine off the top of my head.
It's Friday.
You can ask. What's that?
You said wine?
Yeah.
It's Friday. It's happy hour. We can talk about
it. Yeah. Come on, wine. Yeah, I'm thinking ahead. As soon as I get off, we're not. Yeah. But you know, like wine, I'm thinking like something they come in your bot. You first thing you ask them is, hey, do you like reds or whites or, you know, all the different types? They're like, great. So when you normally get a bottle, do you usually spend about $10, $50 or $100 or whatever, you know, you're breaking it down. So you start asking these questions. Oh, do you like to throw parties? How often are you buying wine? Next thing you know, you've got them all broken down. You know their favorite brands, you know their flavors, you know how often they're buying, you know how much they're spending. Now, in a couple of days, when you send out that 1 or 2 messages, you can send out a laser-focused message. Hey, Bob, you know what? We have this special going out on Reds right now, and if you buy 3, you can actually get, you know. So now you're walking them through the ladder. The other thing cool about that is in Messenger now, you can actually accept payments. So if a person wants to buy the wine, they can buy it inside a Messenger. They don't have to leave and go to a different website or anything like that. And then to top that, this is going to blow your mind. When you can make purchases, you can set it up so it has upsells and downsells within Messenger.
Really?
So like if I buy my bottle of wine, like one, I can actually have it. Next message is going to say, hey, I saw you buy this one, but right now we have a special. So if you buy 3 or more, you're going to save X or whatever your upsell or downsell. It could be a wine cork. You know, hey, we see you buy a lot of wine. Here's a cork just to help you. Yeah. you know, whatever your upsells or downsells are going to be. But you can actually do that in Messenger now for a whole marketing aspect.
Is that one click?
Yeah.
You could do it with
one. I mean, well, okay. Right. So the purchase itself, you do have to one time enter the credit card information. But once you do, it's stored in Facebook. But after that, it is one click. Yes.
So how is that? I'm sorry.
Go ahead.
I want to know. Like, are you setting this up through like a Facebook payments? Or is it
Stripe to ManyChat and then you're good to go. Wow. Would you, let's see, while we're talking here, I can actually show you some amazing stuff that's happening right now in Messenger.
Absolutely.
Let me see, pull something up while we're talking here.
So, I knew that you could take payments. I had no idea that you could do one click upsells now in it. That is literally...
It's a very little known true thing they do, but once you set it up, they have the ability down below it to continue on with different messages. And you can set conditions. So if they've made certain purchases or another, you can send them a certain route or they won't send a certain route.
Wow.
And one more thing, I know this is crazy. You can now do split testing, A-B split testing inside. So if you want to test a headline or a font or an image or a video, you can actually do split testing and it tracks it all for you.
And we're getting kind of deep, but I want to know this now. So if you do like a broadcast in ManyChat, mm-hmm. and say you're only selecting a certain people, let's say, hey, we're only going to message the people that selected that they like red wine.
Right.
You could set it up where it has two different headlines going out to, let's say, that group of 1,000 people. And Jay say, oh, this message will be sent to 500 and this message will be sent to 500.
Alexa, stop it. Sorry. Alexa, stop it.
But then you could send it to 500 and 500 or something like that?
Yes, it'll do an even split and it'll send. And then it'll be able to, that way you're able to track your clicks from there, depending on, you know, oh, we sent 500 there, but only 80% click compared to the 500 we sent here and only 30% or whatever. But yes, A-B split testing, just like that.
Wow, that is huge.
It really is. It's really, it's crazy the amount of stuff you're able to do right now. And Messenger, it's getting even crazier. Did you know that by the end of summer, that Messenger is going to actually have AR platform that's embedded into its platform? So augmented reality. So
yeah. I've seen people doing, I forget what his name is, but he does like a virtual reality, like Facebook Lives.
Like Jay Hunter?
Yes. I think that's him. And I'm like, wow, Jeff, that's Hunter? Freaking amazing. I totally want
to. So this is not that though.
No.
Watch. Let me see here. I have a video. Okay, here we go. This is the one that I wanted. No, that's not it. So, but I'll just explain to you. So what they're doing now is Sephora Makeup is one of the leaders in makeup industry. Mm-hmm. You have the ability that's going to, and this will be on every Messenger, so it's being built in, whether you like it or not, it's being built in by Facebook. You're going to be able to hold your phone up, and this is more for ladies than us guys, but some guys probably, but more for ladies than guys. You'll be able to hold your phone up, and then it'll show you the flip version. So like you're looking at yourself for like a selfie, you know? You'll be able to scroll through the different types of products. So if I want to do lipstick or eyeshadow, when you get to eyeshadow, you hit it, then you can go scroll through what colors they have. When you hit that, it puts it on you in 3D, so you're seeing the product on yourself. So let's be honest, when someone sees like a lipstick or something, unless it sucks and it's ugly, they bought it already in their mind. It's on their body.
That is ridiculous.
Right. Wow. Beyond that,
like
you can actually, I know it's crazy. They have it so that you can share that image with your friends and ask their opinions. So now I have a picture of me with this makeup on. I'm singing to all my girlfriend or guy friends or whomever. And they're going to actually, well, that's awesome. You know what? There's a button below it so I can buy it too. What do you know?
Yeah. That is
multiple level marketing here. Wow, and we're not even gotten into actual real engagement yet. This is just superficial selling stuff.
Yeah. I mean, that is insane. I mean, think of the industries that could use this. Just like people with glasses, like literally anything. I mean,
anything.
T-shirts,
anything,
like, hey, you know, like, oh, here's me on this t-shirt and you just show me how I look with another t-shirt.
eBay right now. You can go to eBay Messenger Bot and like they have that. And what you can do too is save shirt sizes and different pant sizes. So then when you see products, they only show you products that are available to your size. Plus, you can select favorites and all that different stuff. It's like in catalogs within catalogs. So you'll start off like maybe top level. You're like looking at pants, search, and shoes. Oh, I just want pants. Now I'll go to dress pants or blue jeans. And it breaks it down. And it's all purchasable inside of Messenger.
When is that? They say that's coming out end of the summer?
No, that's here now. The AR stuff's coming out at the end of summer.
Yeah, the AR stuff is coming out at the end
of
summer.
Yeah, but everything else other than the augmented reality stuff we're talking about, that's all out right now. Like I've got right now for a demo bot, I've got a 27 product e-com bot based off of a clothing line that does that. It walks you through and has like the shirts, shoes, and everything, and walks you through. And then if you buy a shirt, it asks you, hey, do you need pants to go with that? Because who doesn't wear pants? And sometimes they'll say like little funny stuff like that.
Yeah, too. And it's amazing how, like, I know some of the people that might be watching right now, like, this sounds complicated. This sounds like way too much effort, but I'm telling you, go in there, spend a couple hours. It's so easy. The way you can tag things in I use personally ManyChat. I'm not sure, is that what you use?
I prefer for everyone. I use Chatfuel as well, but Chatfuel is way more technically like scary. Like I tell you, it's intimidating if you don't know where ManyChat, when you log in, especially the flow builder, it's so easy to use. And it's just very logical. This goes to here and this goes here. So connect it all and setting up tags so you can track people. Yeah. I tell people a lot, it's not as hard as you think. At the base level, you know, for someone that's starting out a business and needs something to like, for instance, the chat bubbles in the corner. Now you can click on that and then you can start chat dialogue. Because one of the things I've always found is when people are going to buy a product, no matter how well you build a page out, there's always that one burning question. If I only knew that question, I'd buy your product. Well, that chat bubble now allows you to go in where you can set up automated messages that will key off of certain words. So if they ask, how much is it? It will recognize how much is it, and it will then send out a message. It's like, oh, our normal price is this. And then again, engaging off those sequences. So the customer has like, I think it is a choose your own adventure book for your product or brand. Mm-hmm. So if they want to engage more in the product, they can go down this road. If they want to learn more about the brand and who you are, they go down this road. You know, it's amazing.
Yeah, it's funny because I started in my e-commerce businesses, I'll have just the chatbot in the funnel, like on the order form. And I remember one day we were having issues with the funnel. Orders weren't going through and somebody wrote, hey, I can't order. And that literally was like my customer support. Like they came and we were able to, you know, resolve the issues, right? Just little things like that just completely replaces some of your like help desk apps, like having that kind of engaging, you know.
I mean, I don't want to say we're putting people out of business here, brother, but in a way it does. I've got some, okay, so like one of my main clients that we've done like 4 million with, his staff is him, his audio person, and he's got a couple of VAs, and that's it, other than me, of course. But, you know, other than that, that's his entire staff, and we've done like 4 million in last year. Mm-hmm. So, I mean, you know, that just shows you the power of something like this, because it is, it's like having your service, your, you know, customer support online 24 hours a day, never tired, not bitchy because they got in a bad day or whatever, you know, and they're able to answer everyone's question and walk them through the customer journey of building up that know, like, and trust factor, because that's just it. I was talking to John Fogelry, I can't think of his last, I'm trying to think of his last name, but he does like roughly 450,000 a month in Facebook ads. And he said back in the day, you used to have 12 touch points, which means someone have to see your product or engage 12 times. Now with the way the internet is, he said it was up to 22 times someone has to be engaged with their brand because they to buy. Now the reason why is this, like for instance, you first hear about something, what's the first thing you do right now? Google it. You might not even be slightly interested, but you're gonna Google it. Touch point number one. Second, someone's gonna mention it somewhere. Touch point number two, you know what I mean? And just because their internet is so much knowledge being thrown upon you and you're not able to absorb it all, that touch point has to go higher and higher. And we have sort of like goldfish brains now, you know, it's like, if it's not keeping my attention for 7 to 8 seconds, I'm changing the channel. Like, you
know? Exactly. That's exactly what's happening. And it's so true. That's a crazy statistic, 22 times.
It really is.
Like when you really think about that, That's what I always recommend. Like, people have like review videos on YouTube, be ranking for your YouTube videos, have a right. Facebook page, at least some reviews in there, you know, maybe throw together some, a little blog, but at least, you know, have that place somewhere. Cause exactly. You never know, you can't, people all take information indifferently, right? Some people might just be, you know, people that just get their information from YouTube. Other people like to read it. Right. So you got to be in all of those areas.
But, you know, that's one of the things, too, that why I tell people, they're like, well, if I'm doing messenger bot, do I need to do email? Yes, you still, because it's a different medium. There are some people that will never open messenger that will read an email and vice versa. Plus, the interaction engagement are two completely different things. And if you just take numbers, let's say 1,000 people, bad open rates right now for bots are 80%. So that means out of 1,000, 800 people are going to see your message. Open rates, good open rates for email, 30%. So right off that just alone, only 300 people compared to 800 are going to see your message. Mm-hmm. Now click-through rates, bad bot click-through rates, 50%. Email click-through rates, 10% if you're blowing it up. So now you take that 800, half of them are going to click through your message. That means 400 people are going to see your message. Where the other one, we've got like, what is it, maybe 80, I think it is, when you do the math, is going to see. So just statistics-wise, the amount of people that are going to see your message in your potential sale or ad or whatever you're trying to get to them is just higher. So it just makes more sense to use bots.
Mm-hmm. No, absolutely. But it's like you mentioned, there's such different mediums. Like you said, like if you could betray their trust, your customer's trust, if you're constantly just spamming them, you know,
you would.
Constantly spamming them with messages. And I see that sometimes from people. Right. I'm like, it's to the point where you're like, people don't even know how to unsubscribe yet. I feel like a lot. It's such a new thing. And people are like, wait, what did I just sign up for? Right. So You really have to like nurture that relationship and like not take advantage of it. Because we have a lot of power as like business owners. We have a lot of power with our customers, data. But I wanted to hit on, if somebody's like just starting out, like how do you get, like if you were just starting out with messenger bots, what would your game plan be to hit that first, like let's say 100 subscribers, something that somebody can do like today after they
listen? That's a great, great question. So the number one way that we get people into our ecosystems are using our lead magnets. You can also do paid ads and things like that. But if you're just starting out, a lot of people don't have a budget to be able to afford paid ads. So like you were saying before, maybe you're shooting a tutorial video for YouTube. Well, in that description, sure, you're going to have the normal description like everybody else, but below that, you're going to have your links that are going to refer to your pages. They're going to refer to whatever, maybe a couple lead magnets. The trick is all those links are what we call messenger bot ref URLs, which refer back to your bot. When they click on that, they subscribe to your bot. So say they want a cheat sheet for how to do YouTube videos. Great. Click on that. They're now taking your bot. They're giving the ability to download the PDF from their Facebook Messenger in your phone. And bam, I've got you a subscriber. So if 100 people download that opt-in, boom, I've got 100 subscribers already that quick.
that's insane. And that's something like literally somebody can do today.
Right now.
Right?
Yeah. Like as soon as we're done, just get off, go sign up. Mini chats, free to start. The high level, when you're paying, it's $10 a month. So that's not a lot of coin. That's for the pro version, so you're able to use all the features, which most likely you'll want to do. Mm-hmm. But yeah, they can hang up, go set up right now, $10, start up their account, hook it up to their business page on Facebook, and within an hour have everything set up and gone. And that's with just like going through courses and trying to figure stuff out. If you really know what you're doing, you can have everything up and running within 30 minutes.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
Easily.
So, question. So I know some people are going to be like, hey, I want to collect both, right? An email and an opt-in, right? I know there are strategies for that. I want to hear your thoughts on it.
So there's a lot. The problem is they have this, that GDPR that just came out that you have to now tell people everything you're doing. So there's stealthy ways that I used to do. For instance, this used to be, oh my goodness, it is beautiful. In ClickFunnels, they have the ability under the settings tab to do a force redirect where you can go after submit, it'll go to a certain URL. Mm-hmm. Well, what you would do or what I would do is put the messenger ref URL in there. So when they click submit to submit their email for the opt-in, it submit the email in ClickFunnels, but it would then shoot them to messenger and double opt them in to both ClickFunnels and messenger at the same time. That was awesome. People would love that. But now, since that GDPR has come out, you have to have a checkbox and you have to let people know, so you can't be stealthy about that. So if you do use that hack, it still works really well. But if you get fined for it or anything happens, it's not on me.
You didn't hear it here, guys.
Right, exactly. You know, but you can always alleviate that too. Like, there's ways around now where they have, like, you can put a checkbox and then put our terms of service. And then in your terms of service, you say something like you're getting opted into ClickFunnels and into Messenger. Mm-hmm. So it's, you know, it's up to them to read into it. So there's ways around it and stuff. But that's the one of the better ways. Another thing I'll do is underneath the email, they'll have, you know, they have the ability to put, I believe it's under Messenger, under the growth tools, it's called checkbox, the actual checkbox. What I'll do is, like, say they're opting into a webinar, all right? So they're going to watch a webinar. Well, underneath that, I'll put that checkbox option, and then I'll say, hey, you know what? Everybody that's watched this webinar has loved this, whatever the coolest lead magnet you have is. Would you like that too? They say yes. Well, now they just opted in your Messenger while they're going to your webinar, you know? So you send them the lead magnet.
I'm curious, can you still have that auto-checked?
The deal is, if you set up your account before August 17th, it's auto-checked. Mm-hmm. If you didn't and it's after August 17th, it's not auto-checked anymore.
Yeah.
So that's the difference. That's why you see some that are auto-checked and some aren't. It just depends on when you set your account up.
Yeah, that's like my biggest fear is, like, I changed for one of my businesses a couple months back now. I changed, like, the business manager on it. And, like, mm-hmm. literally that same day, they stopped allowing people to sign up for ManyChat. And that's, like, what are your thoughts on that? Like, do you have, like, any kind of, like, fears in the future with people, like, complaining about it? And, like,
no, you know what I mean? Because I know ManyChat is going to do everything in their power to make sure that people are compliant and they're putting out a good experience. And things like this where people are now putting out the good message that they're really saying, you know, it's about engagement. It's about talking to your customer. It's not about just, hey, here's an ad. I'm going to put an ad in your face. There's an ad. That's not what it's all about, you know. So and I, as much as you can sell a messenger, you know, realize that's not what it's about. It's about cultivating relationships and engaging with your customer on an intimate level. Because think about this, too. When you're writing a message and we're going back and forth on Messenger, do you write 17 bubbles and then I respond? No, it's like you'll say something and then I say something and then you say something. When you design out messengers in Messenger, keep that in mind. No one wants to hear bing and they start reading about halfway through it. Another one comes up and they got to scroll back down. That's the most annoying thing ever. So you have to keep that experience and that journey in mind when you're building out your message.
Yeah, no, absolutely. So you kind of hit on this one earlier. I was going to ask you about it. Like, what's your strategy for, like, kind of nurturing that list? Like, you already mentioned you recommend, you know, 3 days a week is a good place to start, but where do you strike the balance, like, of value versus, you know, an actual promotion? Like, once they get on the list, you start trying to sell, like, usually with email, yeah, you want to nurture it, value, and then product. So I would look to know.
I subscribe to the good old Gary V philosophy. Same thing here. Yeah. You know, like, even maybe more so, man. And maybe it's like jab, right hook, you know? because that's just it. No one wants, or no one's ready to yet have, every time they look in their phone and see a message from you, it's a sale. No, you will get unsubscribed so darn fast. They will literally shut your account down. And then, okay, so here's something else too that's very important. There's called 24+1. This is a rule put out by a messenger that you're allowed to engage with someone with a promotional message for 24 hours, and then you get one more shot after that 24 hours. Now, what that means is if someone doesn't engage with your message, click on it, type in it, whatever, in that time frame, you can no longer message them legally unless they interact with your bot.
Okay. Yes. Really? I thought okay. All
right. What's that?
I thought that was actually, like, you can't send them essentially like a promotion.
Right. That's what I meant. Like a promotion. Like, exactly. Mm-hmm. Right. Like, if I'm sending a video or something, that's fine. But, like, I forgot off track there. But yes, as far as promotional stuff, the 24+1, you can't engage with them unless they engage with their bot. Now, if it's just like regular content, like a video or something like that, you can send those out whenever or however. But as far as a promotion, a lot of times if I know I'm going to put a promotion out, I'll send out a message and then have a silly, like, little, like, say it's a video, yes or no, like, did you like it, yes or no, or how did you think about it, just so they'll click something so that they'll all be in that promotional 24-hour window, so that way I don't get in trouble.
Oh, I see. So I see. So they have to, okay, that makes sense. So just to explain to everyone, and hopefully I got this right, because I'm probably the worst follower of this rule. I think we all are fall victim to that. So you would send them a broadcast message. Let's say you're doing a promotion this weekend. So you would send out, let's say, an hour before, a message that they essentially, if they see it, they would respond to it. Like a yes, yeah,
like
or
a,
no.
Like a foolproof message that's like, you know, like just like a cute or a quick video or something and say, hey, did you like it? And like, you know, most people are going to say yes, just so you can get that engagement up. So then the next day when you decide to send out the promotional, mm-hmm. all these people, because they engage with their bot, now fall in that promotional window. Exactly. That might not had not fallen in had you not sent out the message prior for them to engage with.
Okay. All right. So I see. Okay. So yeah, you can't just go in and broadcast promotion.
Right. They'll shut your account down. They'll so literally turn your account off.
Is ManyChat the one that's kind of like, I guess Facebook's like on them consistently to making sure that they're enforcing the rules on us, right? So you don't want to kind of betray that trust, because essentially this is ManyChat's business on the line, right? So
100%. And that's one reason why you know that they're going to constantly be evolving and making sure that people are within guidelines. Because if Facebook cuts off like they did the pause that where they had out of nowhere, where they're just like, hey, guess what? No one can do anything for till we decide. Who's to say it couldn't happen again? So ManyChat's going to always try and be as compliant and make sure that everyone using it is compliant as well.
Mm-hmm. So as far as the growth strategies, like what is your, even with the tools specific, like which one's your favorite? Like I'm partial to like the JSON one preferably, mm-hmm. but like I'm curious since I haven't honestly been in the Messenger bot for a couple weeks now. I'm just curious to know like, what strategies are really working well, like right now, that people can implement?
The JSON's pretty good for like when I'm running ads and stuff like that. But the ones that I like to use mainly are the Messenger ref URLs, because it's a link, and that link can be hidden in a button or on an image that can be clicked, or it can be an actual link itself. And when you click on it, it takes you directly into the message sequence, so you get to skip any type of like that. Like normally, when someone clicks a button. Like if you make a button inside Messenger, because you have many different growth tools or ways, as you know, to get into Messenger. Mm-hmm. But when you use the button message, it will still send them to the part where they have to click get started first, you know, and then you have to go through the welcome message, that type of thing. Where when you use the Messenger ref growth tool, it takes them directly to that message. So it almost
it opens it in their Messenger?
Oh, yeah, it skips through the whole intro part.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, so it's like a quick way not to lose your people through your bot. So that's one of my favorites for that reason. Plus, it can just be hidden almost anywhere. It's a link, so if you can hide it in a link, you can put it there. The second one I always use is the button, because you can actually just take a button and embed it. I use ClickFunnels all the time, as you know, so the ability to embed that. And then the last one I usually use would be like the pop-ups, where it'll be like a slide in from the side or from the top. It'll just be like a little, hey, would you like you? You know, the cool thing about the pop-ups is you can set them to whether there'll be someone scrolled down a certain amount on the page, or maybe they've been on the page for a certain amount of time. So they're reading your blog or whatever. Well, after, say, a minute, all of a sudden it slides in. Hey, I see that you like this blog. Would you be interested in this lead magnet or to go in another blog or whatever?
Yeah, I mean, it's like an insane amount of opportunities available. That's why I worry sometimes, like people that will listen to this and be like, oh man, this is just too complicated. But it really isn't, guys. Like honestly, start with one tool. Start with maybe adding like the chat bubble or something like that. Like, do you have any? I know we're hitting up to almost 45 minutes now. I want to be respectful of your time.
No worries.
But like some final words, because I know a lot of people are still not using this.
Right. Well, before you said the chat bubble, so before we move on to the final words, let's talk about chat bubble real quick, because that is huge. I recommend if you have an order form and you don't have a chat bubble on there, you're probably missing out on 10 to 15% lift in your conversion. Because like I spoke on this before, there could be that one burning question. This is how you're going to be able to answer that burning question. They're going to be able to click on that little button there and then type in what their question is, or you might have a list of frequently ask questions they can choose from. The chat bubble is hugely important. Now, I don't want everybody to get confused, because that's not the main way you're going to get people into your bot, but it's definitely one of the main ways that you're going to be able to help answer those burning questions and sell those products. So again, like you're saying, I would pick like one growth tool, learn how to master that, and move on to the others, because there are about 10 to 15 or 12 different ones. But really, you're going to find out that eventually you're going to only use probably 3 or 4 of them. Like, really, that's all out of like the 12 there are. I probably use 4 of them on a regular basis.
Oh, yeah. One little ninja thing that I've been using, at least in e-commerce, is have on an exit pop on your order form, have the chat function out. I'd be like, hey, do you have any questions, like final questions about it? Like, usually I had like, oh, hey, have a coupon code if you want to, complete your purchase. But now I've been adding that in. And guys, like, honestly, that helps, like, in product development, market data, right, that you're going to be able to use to, you know, honestly, write your own copy. I mean, the things that you're going to get so much market research just from seeing the customer's language that they're using and the issues that they're having, that they're going to write the copy for your website for you to address those problems, you know?
So check this out. Here's another ninja trick that I like to use. For onboarding procedures, like they buy your product and there's a walkthrough that they normally have to go through, whether it's registering and signing up, on my thank you page, I'll have a button, start your walkthrough now, and they'll click it and the bot will go through, hey, welcome on board. We just want to show you. Here's step one. Here's what you're going to do. Step two, you're going to go to my Facebook group. You're going to sign up. Step three, you're going to go here, and now you're going to set up your membership site or whatever. But it'll literally walk through, just like customer service, walks them through the whole process. So it cuts down on those people calling up, oh, I don't know how to log in or do my email. You know, there's stupid questions people ask sometimes.
I absolutely love that, because I preach continuity programs, and people will be like, okay, I joined this continuity program in the funnel, but like, how does everything else work, right? Oh, I absolutely love that idea of having
a long process. It really cuts down on the friction for the customer. It makes the journey from purchase to being able to engage with your product so much easier.
Wow. No, I'm totally stealing
that. Nice. Very cool.
So we're nearing close to our hour here. So any final words? Any final tips for anybody here?
No, man, just get on ManyChat and start playing around with it. You know, it's a fun thing. Once you start figuring out and the light bulbs start going off, it's just going to be something that you're going to be like, why haven't I been using this before now?
I know. And they are, like you said, they're actually really fun to use. Once you kind of get it down, it's like, wow, I can do this. And it's just like, it's a whole separate funnel, guys. It's the messenger bot funnel, right?
So, and you can even play games with them and stuff. Like, I'll have people that will like, the trivia game, or they're like, roll a dice. You can set it so it has a 50-50 thing on there, and you'll be rolling dice, and so it's like a little mini gambling. It's amazing what you can do now. It's crazy. And we never even mentioned this. They're going to be opening API up for developers. So soon, other like major platforms, like for instance, real estate, they have this thing called like the MDX or something, which is a listing of all the properties available in an area. They're going to be able to integrate that in a messenger. So you'll be able to type in a zip code, how many bedrooms you want, what type of, you want a pool, how much you want to pay. Okay, here's what's listed. Boom.
Wow.
Yeah, that's just the beginning. Once they start opening this up and you'll be able to integrate other platforms, like for instance, you'll be able to book airline tickets soon directly in your messenger bot. I mean, it's going to get crazy. In the next 3 to 6 months, Messenger is pushing to be the number one engagement platform in the world.
And that's why I recommend, I'm like start doing now. It's so cheap right now to get started. Like later on, it's not going to be easy to get these kind of opt-ins. Like right now, it's still kind of like the wild, wild west, and you could probably get away with some of these little gray hat techniques that we talked about. But like, once bigger players start getting into this, once more regulations come into play here, it's not going to be hard. I mean, it's going to be a little bit more harder, but you know, take advantage of it while you can. You know, take advantage of, you know.
Well, and think about this. Do you want to be, when it comes to riding the wave, do you want to be on the top and the crest, or you want to be that guy that just missed it, that's just still trying to paddle up and catch up to everybody, you know? Exactly. Now's the time to be at the forefront and be a leader rather than a follower, you know? Mm-hmm.
Absolutely. So, Jeff, where can they contact you if they want to learn more about what you're doing?
The best thing right now would be probably just my my Facebook page, Banek Digital Marketing, right now, because it's crazy to say I have so much stuff going on that I haven't consolidated everything. So that's the easiest place to get a hold of me right now.
Awesome, dude. Well, again, thank you. Thank you so
thank
much.
Thank you, brother. For, I appreciate it.
For you know, taking some time out of your day, especially on a Friday, right?
Yeah, no worries, man. I'm here for the community. I want everybody. I look at it like this. I'm blessed. My job, if someone watches this and it helps expand their business and they grow, from the knowledge we've been able to share right now, we're changing people's lives, man. You're giving people's jobs. You're giving someone a family that didn't have a future, that went broke. Now they're able to buy their kids Christmas presents. I mean, you know, I don't want to sound like crazy, but we're changing the world through just doing stuff like this. And that's why I do this, is because I know someone's going to watch us out there. It's going to make a difference, and it's going to give them that inspiration they need to keep fighting when they're having that rough day, you know?
Exactly. And that's what I preach. I'm like, hey, look, me and Jeff here, we're normal people. Like, you know what I mean? We just put in the time, we put in the work, we made it happen for ourselves. And I always say this to everybody. I'm like, trust me, I'm just some dude from Philadelphia. If I was able to do it, like, I truly believe anybody can do it too.
Tell me about it, brother, man. I talk to my buddy Kevin, the guy that helped me to get this, every day, and I'm just like, man, if I'd never met you, who knows, I'd still, you know, I mean, you never know. You just be prepared, because when the opportunity arises, you want to make sure you're ready for it. So, you know, what do they say? Luck is when opportunity meets preparedness, I believe, yes. Or something like yes. that. So yes. Don't always be lucky, let's say then. Always be
exactly.
lucky.
Exactly. All right. Thanks again, Jeff, so much, man.
It was a pleasure, Peter. Have a good one, brother.
You too.